Gospels go with me to Luke 24th chapter, beginning at verse number 50. Amen. Amen. Luke 24, beginning at verse number 50. And you have it signified by saying amen.
Amen.
Luke's writing in the 24th chapter, the 50th verse, and it reads on this wise. And he led them out as far as to Bethany, and he lifted up his hands and blessed them. And it came to pass, while he blessed them, he was parted from them and carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and were continually in the temple praising and blessing God. Amen. I want to talk from the subject, trouble don't last always. Trouble don't last always. Father, we talk, God, we thank you again for this day. We thank you again for all of your blessings. Thank you for the songs. Thank you for the prayers, God. Thank you for the praises that have been sent up to you. But now, God, we need to hear from heaven. Pray now you will speak again, anoint afresh, bind them in the name I thank you. God, we need all of you. And now we, Lord, thou art the Father, I am the Christ, and I'm the Lord away. In your Son Jesus' name, amen. Trouble don't last always. Job was right. When Job said that man that is born of a woman is of a few days, and they are full of trouble. Old folks will say that if it ain't one thing, it's another. Seems like every time we turn around, trouble is overtaking the land. Look at the news and we see that our school system is in trouble. Although we see all of our educators being hauled off to jail, even though it's a white collar crime, let us know that trouble is in the land. But I'm glad trouble don't last always. When you look around and see how many young brothers have lost their lives to senseless killing, whether they're killing one another or being shot down by the police, let us know that there's trouble in the land. When you look at the attacks on our president, not because of his character, but because of the color of his skin, it lets us know that there's trouble in the land. But I'm glad today that trouble don't last always. Some of us today who are going through something, been wrestling with something, been dealing with something, and can't seem to find your way out. And instead of things getting better, it seems like it only get worse. But I come today to encourage you that trouble don't last always. Raised up from the dead. Mary had got to the tomb and met Jesus along the way and didn't even know who he was. She had looked in the tomb and saw not the body of Jesus. She had ran and got Peter and told Peter, and Peter told John, and John did outrun Peter to the sepulcher and found that the body was gone. And here they are now, they're sad. Amen. Mary had been in the garden weeping because it's troubled times, and she had supposed Jesus to be the gardener. And Jesus said, Mary, and she recognized his voice and said, Master. But the boys, Peter was somewhere hiding, amen. The boys were somewhere behind locked doors. And two disciples, amen, that was on their way to a village called the Emmaus village. Amen. They were journeying along from Jerusalem. And as they journeyed, amen, they was walking with their head down. They were walking and they were sad. so that whatever you're going through, there's no reason to be sad. Whatever you're dealing with, there's no reason to be down and out. Because God has not forgotten you. He promised you He'd never leave you nor forsake you, but He'd be with you always to the end of the world. They continued walking and was walking at sand. And while they were walking, Jesus showed up. And Jesus drew near to them, but they didn't know who He was. Jesus said, well, what manner of conversation are you having? That you're walking and you're sad. I said, Jesus, you're just a stranger here in Jerusalem. You don't know those things that have come to pass. You don't know what happened last week. You don't know how they whooped him, scratched him, mocked him. You're a stranger. You don't know how they hung him on an old rugged cross. You weren't here. You don't know how they nailed his hand and how they pierced him in the side. You weren't there when all of these things happened to Jesus. But you know what? Our stranger, we trusted that he would be the Redeemer of Israel. And we believed that he would be the one that would overthrow Roman Greco rule. We just thought that he was the man for the job. Somebody ought to know what I'm talking about. And our hearts are heavy. And we're dealing with some troubled times. And not only that, but there's a rumor going around that there was a lady there that said she had a vision and he was not there at the tomb. And what made it so bad? What made it so bad besides all of this stuff happened now is 3 days later and they talking about they can't find his body and they seen a vision of angels that say he is alive. Anybody that know that Jesus is alive? I got anybody that know just because last Sunday was Resurrection Sunday, your praise shouldn't stop on this Sunday because you got a God that's alive and well. I don't know about some of y'all, but I know my God is alive and well. I know he rose from the dead. I know he ascended up out that grave without the shadow. Begin to talk to them about the scriptures concerning him. And as he talked to them, they say, one to another as he vanished off, as he went his way, they say, did not our hearts burn within us while we reasoned by the wayside? And they got up and returned back to Jerusalem. And when they got to Jerusalem, they find the boys sitting there together. And they walked over to them and said, the Lord is risen indeed and has appeared to Simon. Now, he appeared to Simon. Who is Simon Peter? And you would say, why would God show up only to Simon Peter? Well, Simon Peter, my brothers and sisters, he had denied the Lord. The Lord had told him that before the cock crow three, before the cock crow, you will have denied me 3 times. And Peter now had denied the Lord 3 times. Now Peter's feeling bad. They tore the things that were gone.
Yeah.
And as they began to break bread,
yeah,
and sat down with the disciples,
yes,
the two that were walking to the Emmaus village, and the 11 that's locked behind closed doors.
Well,
and they sat down now after the two had told them that Jesus had rose. Locked up behind closed doors when Jesus told them they should be spreading the gospel. Are y'all hearing me? Too many of us are locked up behind closed doors. Too many of us are scared to tell the word of God. I was just with some ministers and I was dealing with some situation with some young brothers last week, and I said, well, when we gonna stand up and speak up? Too many of us are scared to stand up and speak up. Too many don't want to trouble the water.
I know you may not have.
you. All things.
Turn it off.